Teachers, we want to thank you for organizing this program for us today, and students for performing, and parents for joining us. The story of Black History Month began in 1915. Half a century after the 13th Amendment abolished slavery in the United States. That September, the Harvard-trained historian Carter G. Woodson and the prominent minister Jesse E. Moreland founded the Association for the Study of Negro Life and History, an organization dedicated to researching and promoting achievements by Black Americans and other peoples of African descent. This event inspired schools and communities nationwide to organize local celebrations, establish history clubs, and host performances and lectures. And it is my privilege to invite you to enjoy our performance today in honor of the achievements of Black Americans and peoples of African descent. So please join me as we enjoy Midnight at the Black History Museum.
My name is Alvin Haley, and I would like to take you on a journey, also known as our Black History Museum. Some of you may not know me, but allow me to introduce myself. I'm a choreographer and an activist who founded the Alvin Haley Dance Theater in New York City, the Big Apple. I popularized modern dance and revolutionized African American participation in 20th century concert dance. My company gained the nickname Cultural Ambassador of the World because of this international tour. My favorite and most choreographed piece is Revelations. It is known to be the best and most seen modern dance performance.
Oh, Baxter one night at the Black History Museum. Four children were doing a project for Black History Month when they suddenly got very sleepy and the museum closed for the night. And they entered into the Black History Museum zone.
It is important to realize that Black History Month was not born in a vacuum. The 1920s saw the rise of interest in African American culture that was representative by the Harlem Renaissance, where writers like Langston Hughes wrote about the Georgia Sirens of Blackness, musicians like Louis Armstrong, Duke Ellington, and myself, Dizzy Gillespie.
Another one. Make that another dozen. Two dozen. Jefferson praised him.
You kids know Harry Tubman, don't you?
Yes.
Child, they call me the conductor on the Underground Railroad. But there are no subway trains involved. The Underground Railroad was a secret system of people of all races who helped slaves get to the north.
There weren't any trains involved?
No, no, no number five, number two, or to everyone.
How did it work?
Well, a lot of slaves wanted to get out of the north, get out of the south, because they didn't have the freedom. So they... The first slaves I freed were my own sister and their family. I had a whole bunch of friends that I was in the house with them today, and at night they head north following the drinking board.
What's the drinking board?
Oh, that's a constellation in the sky called, a little different. At the tip of the handle is the North Star, so slaves need to follow us to head north. But instead of getting away, our plan is by saying head north, slaves head north. We would say, follow the drinking board, follow the drinking board. You get a lot of slaves' help.
But I was raised by my grandmother and taught to read by the wife of the man who owned me. That was the key that opened the door. Through life, I learned about the unfair slavery was in when I was older. I escaped and moved to the north, and I had one purpose, to wipe out slavery. And I met the honest Abe Lincoln many times during the Civil War. Ain't it, Mr. Lincoln?
That's right. Mr. Douglas and I had plenty to talk about. He taught me about how to be a more honest man back in 1861. Later on, I signed the Emancipation Proclamation.
What's that?
I think I'll let Mrs. Jones Truth tell you that.
That was a law all across the nation, north and south, that said that slavery was wrong, and every slave should be given his or her own freedom. It was something I was fighting for a lot. It took all those boys down just to get signed. I guess that's why they say freedom ain't free. I remember how many times we saved ourselves from papers, and finally, it became reality. Oh, no, honey. My birth name is Isabel Sunfree, but I took the name to Jonah Truth in 1843 because I believe God wanted me to be a traveling preacher. See, that's what Jonah Truth means, a traveling preacher.
Oh.
Yes, Mr. Jonah Truth met me in the White House too. Did you?
I sure did. As I remember, I was yelling. I mean, talking kind of loudly about how it wasn't fair that streetcars drawn cars were segregated by race.
That was something I couldn't fix for black people. If you remember your history, I was shot before I could do any more for black people. But I can introduce you to a young woman who did, about 90 years later, Miss Rosa Parks. Hello, children.
Hey, Miss Rosa Parks.
Hi.
I also know that blood days ain't coffee. As young as just come south, I actually have my own share of problems. I imagine one of my utopia go far away from the racism in the south. I even wrote a song about the most blood utopia.
Stop a minute and hold me along. We're not together. 381 days. That's more than a whole year.
What happened after that?
The people of Montgomery were represented by a man named Thurgood Marshall.
Hello, that was quite a time for us. Quite a very important decision. Do you remember when the soldier at Tucson was elected and it wasn't fair the horseshoe carriage to sex man?
Yes.
Well, about 100 years later, on November 13, 1956, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled that bus segregation was unconstitutional.
And later, Mr. Marshall became the first African-American on that same Supreme Court. So you can see how things have changed. Now there's one more song you got to hear, a song of hope.
Hey, we got a call from someone. How do we consider this as closing time?
But we're talking to look at the paintings.
Oh, you're done. The princess is going sick. Come on, let's go.
Goodbye. Thank you.
Good morning, my name is Yukai Lai. Many of you might not know this, but the Haim, Live Every Voice and Sing, was publicly performed first as a poem, as part of a celebration of Lincoln's birthday on February 12, 1900, by 500 school children at Stanton School. Its principal, James William Johnson, wrote the words to introduce in honor of Booker T. Washington. The poem was later set to music by Johnson's brother John in 1905. Singing this song quickly became a way for African Americans to demonstrate this patriotism and hope for the future and cause for earth and heaven to reign. With the harmonies of liberty, they can speak out against racism and Jim Crow's laws. In 1919, the NAACP adopted the song as the Negro National Anthem. By the 1920s, Live Every Voice and Sing could be found in black churches across the country. During and after the American Civil Rights Movement, the song experienced rebirth, and by the 1930s, with Autumn Song immediately after the Star Spangled Banner. At public events and performances across the United States, where the event had significant African American population. On January 20th, 2009, the Reverend Joseph Lowry used the third stanza to begin his integration ceremony for President Barack Obama. Lift every voice and sing to earth and heaven's ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our souls rise high as the listening sky. Let it resound loud as a rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on to victory this morning.
Stony the road we trod, meadow the chastening road, felt in the days of when hope unborn had died. Yet with a steady beat we have not our very feet. Come to the place for which our fathers sighed. We have come over a way that tears has been watered. We have come treading our path through the flood of the slaughter, out from the gloomy past, till now we stand at last, where the white gleam of our bright star is cast.
God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who has brought us this far on the way, thou who has brought thy might, lead us into the light, keep us forever in the path we pray. Let us not be strayed from the place our God, where we met thee. Lest our hearts drunk with the wine of the world, we forgive thee. Shadow of thee, thy hand, may we forever sing. To our God, to thy name.
God, will you please stand while the orchestra performs the hymn that is also known as the Negro National Anthem. Lift every voice and sing.
Thank you.
one more. Group except drama, and they are drama one. So fabulous job! Thank you, parents, for joining us today. We're going to do this again next Friday for several elementary schools as we try to recruit a new sixth grade class. So thank you very much.